are off to Kooroorinya Falls. What we think. Well, we're not sure if we're going the right way, but we'll check it out. And apparently the Prairie Pub is really nice, so we will stop there for this evening for dinner. And out in the distance is the Hewenden Wind Farm. It's not in full operation yet. And today... comes the motorbike. Just drive really slow, but you don't want to spray them. Hey, gorgeous girl.
Hey, mate.
You're beautiful.
I think he's pushing them. Here he comes, Dad. He's gonna push him again.
More of the herd.
So, Navosha, when you're driving along the road,
must be this property.
Just be careful of the cattle. Slow down. You never know where they're gonna go. It's a safety tip from Brent instead.
There's a big one.
I hope I got that. Oh, she's huge. Look at her. Or is it a boy?
No, they're all girls.
Oh, they're all girls.
Yeah. All the bigger ones are girls.
It's quite a mix of breeds.
These ones are coming right to us.
Yeah.
Hello.
And this little lonely little Moo Moo standing at the cattle grid wants to come and play. Oh no, he's not alone. He's got, there's two of them.
He can smell his friends.
They want to go play with their friends, but they can't because the cattle grid's in the way. Come on, girls. That's it. Move your bottoms. Track out to Kooroorinya Reserve. And they have once a year the picnic races are held here, amateur picnic races. Oh, this is just beautiful. Would be absolutely beautiful in the wet season when it would be in full flood. There'd be waterfalls everywhere. Just gorgeous. So this is where the waterfall would be if it was flowing. Daredevils, Deb and Steve. Dun, da, 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 dun, dun, da, da, da. Mission Impossible. And who says Deb's not adventurous? And here is my husband doing anything it takes to get the ultimate shot of the day, even if it means risking his safety. This to be a fossil, but I can't get it out. Steve, the explorer. And Steve found a little hobbit hole, just his size. Today's fly level is a bit more than moderate. Stared down by a moo moo. Okay, move. Move.
Hey.
Come on, move. The prairie pup. Prairie pub. And they tell us this is the corporate box of the prairie pub. This is a bit posh. arrived at Porcupine Gorge. Warning, cliff edge. Brett? Oh, I've lost him already. He's fallen off the cliff. No, just jokes.
Gorge appears.
That's pretty cool. And can we hear it whistle? That's just too cool. And we're starting the trek to Porcupine Gorge, down into the gorge. So we are going down the track into the gorge. Steve's taking photos of me as I'm taking video of him. And here comes the love of my life, hobbling down the stairs. Well, it doesn't look much of a hobble because I sped it up, but don't tell him that. His gouty ankles were very problematic for him. And here comes Deb. Who would have thought she had a twisted ankle? Doesn't look like it to me. Trying to get the photo of the day. We've started a competition to see who can take the best photo for the day. Deb won yesterday, and Brett's trying like anything to win today.
So I'm going to really struggle getting up.
Rock formations. The base of this canyon was made over 500 million years ago, which is bloody incredible. Not looking forward to going back up, but you'll enjoy a lot.
Well, you can see it, but the sand is glistening with diamonds. Oh my god, it's beautiful. There is just so much silicate in this sand. It's just fun.
And the water's quite cool. Just beautiful. Deb made it. Woo!
Gotta go back yet.
Shh, we won't talk about going back.
Sitting by a cool stream. In an absolute picturesque place. I am in love with Porcupine Gorge. And we're back to the top. And we are buggered. Okay, say hi everybody. So we're having dinner in Hewarden with Sue and Darren before they drive off home. And we're off.
Flash tickies. Up the lawn, hill and back.